If you can't stand Monday morning and you want to stay in bed all day yawning, then come with me, Monday Meandering, even when it's raining.
Just going to walk around. Today I'm in Chiswick and just been into Robert Dias. Has anyone else found the irony hilarious that in Robert Dias they actually have locks and padlocks with security tags on them in case people steal them? I've never noticed that before. And now I might go into Sainsbury's, or I might pop into, Paper Chase. I love Paper Chase. I had to prowse myself out of there because once you get into Paper Chase, you can easily start spending your cash. I'm a bit worried about Paper Chase actually, because they're in a bit of a financial situation at the moment. But I'm sure it'll be fine. Everyone loves Paper Chase. It just needs, I don't know what it needs actually. Because everyone, not everyone obviously loves stationery, but this weight rose, it's so trusting. All that stuff outside where people are expected to take it inside and pay for it. And there's absolutely no way that'd happen if there was a weight rose in all. They'd even security tag the trolleys a bit. Whenever WH shit. Wait, under the WH is lit up. I'm not going in there. Not fond of WH. As you know. But there is a Targa coming up. So let's have an ogling Targa. Look. Just getting run over. By a Ford. Don't see many of them around anyway. Anyway, I'm going in Targa. I don't know what I want though. This is another shop where you can easily go in and spend way too much of your cash. Well, I'd love to take you in obviously, but I don't want to get done for copyright, you know, because of music and stuff. I'm just about to go into Sainsbury's box and just need a few things. But I don't know if I can be bothered dragging milk all away. I might just get it from Co-op instead. A huge fruit and veg stall behind me. Always looks nice, fruit and veg, doesn't it? But I never eat any. As you probably know, slop potato. Just fruit and veg, but nice to look at. It looks so fresh. I'm going to go into Sainsbury's box now. They don't usually have music playing in here, so hopefully I'll be able to get bits in here. Toilets and baby change area behind me. Always makes me laugh, baby change though, because you know, if you get fed up with your baby, get a new one. And Sainsbury's offers that service. It doesn't, obviously. Here we are again in a supermarket. In the UK, Sainsbury's obviously about to merge with Asda. Now, the standards in Sainsbury's have been dropping a bit. They've started stacking food on top of the shelves, which is normally a Tesco thing. But, see, this is why I like home delivery, because then you don't have to listen to screaming kids. I'm already on the World Food Hall. See if there's anything random I can get from down here. But see what I mean about stacking stuff on top of shelves? Sainsbury's didn't used to do that, and I don't know why they're doing it. It looks really horrible. And look, we've got deluxe guava. Now, I've never had mediocre guava, but I might try some deluxe guava. Deluxe mango as well. No, I'm not. It's quite dear, actually. Oh, that for a bit of squashed fruit. Yeah, I'm gonna get that. What shall I get? I'm gonna put the camera down so I can think properly. I wasn't out on the world food bits that I wanted to try. But I am near the tat area. The reduced to clear section. Just having a look what there is. And I have found a Sauvignon Blanc vinegar. which I would just love to give to someone as a joke, you know, because from a distance you might say, oh, look, a bottle of wine, and it's not at all. I don't know why it's on Less Chance to Buy at £2.25. That's not an offer. They've even put a best before on vinegar. Good grief. Ridiculous, isn't it? And there's no one there that I want either. The reason why I'm in here actually is because this is what I do when I'm trying to find food to review. I just meander around a supermarket. It is the law as well that when you work in a supermarket, every single cage and every single trolley must rattle. I can't see anything new yet. There's some Oreo eggs. But I already know what Oreo tastes like. 10 different gazillion formations of Oreo all of a sudden. So in the UK, Oreo barely existed about 10 years ago. Then all of a sudden it all just came at once and it's just in everything. I'm half expecting an Oreo coffee soon. Oh, I'm getting an echo around here. Oh, that's because it's nice and open how Sainsbury's used to be, with no tat above the shelves. But if you look behind me, there it all is. That big bag of sugar there, look. How many kilograms? 5 kilograms of sugar. 5 kilograms. Sugar. Ooh, near the cakes. I wonder if they're still in that deal with Patisserie Valerie since they went into administration. Because I said it was a bad idea, didn't I? I thought it was a bit suspicious, this selling cakes at Sainsbury's thing from Patisserie Valerie, because it's just like, well, it's going to stop people going to your shops. So when that fraud happened, maybe, I don't know, maybe they knew they was doing fraud in the shops. But I can't see no Pat Val cakes anymore. No, I think they've all gone. Yeah, there's no Pat Val cakes anymore. Right, bread. I was watching a YouTube video on YouTube and it was this American girl, and she was saying that none of the British bread was fresh because it had real short dates on it. But that's because British bread doesn't have any artificial preservatives in it, so it really is fresh bread. And we tend not to put sugar in it either, which blew my mind, how they put sugar in bread in America. It's like flipping heck. But I love Ovis. I love Ovis, but I do like Warburton's as well. They're my two favourite branded breads. Not fond of Kingsmill anymore. Although Kingsmill's like the really popular one in the UK at the moment. There used to be one called Mother's Pride, which I always thought was funny. I think they're trying to bring them back, Mother's Pride. Can you imagine if it was called Dad's Pride? You can imagine all the like feminists kicking off. For some bizarre reason, there's a pizza reduced in the bread section. Well, I suppose it's bread somewhere, isn't it? This looks actually quite nice. Sourdough based pizza topped prepared in store for you. I think that's meant to be in a fridge. Oh, it smells gorgeous actually. I might still buy that. No, but. Fruit loaf. I love fruit loaf. Once you get started on a loaf of fruit loaf, that is it. You'll be eating it till it's all gone. But I'm not going to get any today. Turn the corner to... Do you know what? I've not reviewed anything like jelly or jammy for a very, very long time. Maybe I should get something from down here. I think I should. There's peanut butter. Suet for dumplings. I don't know what to get. This is all like the seeds and nuts and stuff. And dried fruit. Ooh, prunes. Shall I review prunes? Just eat an entire bag, see what happens. No, I am not going to do that. And if you don't want them in a bag, you can get them in a can. I tried some strawberries in syrup. Some canned strawberries. Oh, look. Oh, they were Val. I thought, oh, never again. I don't need to buy eggs, but I've got a long way to get back home. And they're just going to get Brock. Oh, that's great English, that, isn't it? Brock. They'll break, rather. Paul Hollywood's got his own range out. Maybe I could review that. Nah, can't be bothered. Because I'd have to do a lot of faffing about with that one. That's for another time, I think. What to get? I just don't know. I don't know if you're enjoying this Meandering Monday video. Just a new idea that I thought. But this is generally what I do when I'm trying to find something for a review. I just go out. I never research anything when I'm reviewing something. I'll just see something that's new or something that's different that I've not seen before and just get it. Such as this Pyrex pie dish. 10-year guarantee. See, I've always wondered things about 10-year guarantee on it. It's just like, well, what am I supposed to do after 9 years and it breaks? What am I supposed to do? Say, oh, it broke. I just give them back all these shards of jagged glass. I've never, ever in my life bought bags of ice. I find it A, a waste of time, and B, what if it melts on the way home? You just got a bag of water. A leaky bag of water. I mean, I've worked in supermarkets, haven't I? Shall I review a leg of lamb? Leg of lamb. Don't think so. I really don't know what I want. Really don't know. There's a new fridge. Almond and Java and vanilla. It's nice, doesn't it? The new, but they've been reduced to £2. Let's have a look. What is this? That actually looks really nice. Oh, never heard of the brand before either. Who is it? It usually says on the back, doesn't it? Blah, 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 blah. Many words. I don't know, but I think I'll review that. That's good. There's only the one flavour. I know there's two. There's Australian macadamia. I'll get both. And hopefully they'll still be frozen by the time I get home. So that's that. Sold. Look at this alcohol-free wine. And you get sparkling as well. Shall I get a bottle for a laugh? Do you know what I think I am? I'm going to go for this one. That is just... What is the point? It's still not 0.05% vol, so I don't understand why it's alcohol. I don't know, I don't care, but I'm going to review it anyway. So... Like that YouTuber said, it's going right in my basket. Well, it is. Look. It's there, look. So I'll get that. I'm not the only one clearly YouTubing in Sainsbury's today. But, now half the reason why I'm getting this bottle of alcohol-free wine is to see if I still get ID'd for it. So, can you imagine getting ID'd for alcohol-free wine? There's nothing new down here. Yeah, I think I'll pay for this, then go. Yeah, I'm going now, I think. I don't want to... Well, I say I don't want to spend too much cash, but I ain't got any cash to spend, hardly. Oh, sorry. Someone's way there. It was just disappeared behind me. Waiting in the queue at self-scan. It's quite dreary, isn't it? But, I'll get a till eventually. Where's the one? Yeah, because there's never no one to call you forward. Oh! Cheers. Right, so, moment of truth. Am I going to get ID'd for alcohol-free wine? I did! I had to get approval of alcohol-free wine. That is hilarious. Well. Wrong. I'm looking forward to it. I can't believe I got ID'd for alcohol-free wine, but then I don't believe I'm buying it. But I'm just really wanting to know what it actually tastes like. Because to me, most wine just tastes the same anyway. It's fucking... I hate when people just burp like that. It's
disgusting, isn't it? Well, anyway, we'll continue on with this meandering Monday. It's getting quite late now, but not late, but dark. Because, what is it, according to the clock? That's 5 o'clock. That's all what churches are to me, just big timepieces. Unless the clock's not working on them, and then it's a waste of time, innit? I think it's not the other way. No, there's not the other way. It's just a load of closed down shops, I think. I'm gonna have a look and see if anything's changed, actually. We just walked past Ramen, which is a much better version of WH Smith, just without the books and newspapers and crap. But for stationery and stuff, it's expensive, but you know it's gonna work. And it's just better customer service as well. I think down here it was just a load of random stuff. And closed down shops. I believe there's still a closed down, what do they call it? Blockbuster Video as well, which is really random. Unless it's gone. I think it has actually. Oh no, it's not, it's there. So I might get the bus back. Oh no, I'm not getting the bus back. I need to start walking more. I need to be walking around more, I think. Oh, that light's nice. Look at that. Ooh, save a couple of quid. Looks nicer if it was higher up, I suppose. You know, if you had a really nice big hallway or landing, it'd be nice, wouldn't it? Oh, look, there's a closed down carpet, right? It says it's carpet wrong now, isn't it? Because it's closed down. There's a slight breeze now, but it's not making it wind noisy on the camera. That one closed down as well. It just actually closed down that shop. Oh, thumb in the way, sorry about that. Blockbuster Video Express. It's been closed down for ages. It's really unusual for shops to do this as well, look, isn't it? Because usually they board everything up. I suppose one day phones will progress to the point that I wonder if that'll happen, because you don't know what's going to happen in the future, do you? What happens if phones become so advanced they're not actually phones anymore? What's going to happen to all the phone shops? We just don't know. Yeah, it seems to be, I think it's just a Chiswick thing, that when a shop shuts down, they don't board it up. Because even this one's not boarded up, this carpet wrong. Look, you can see inside. I love carpet shops though, don't you? If you've ever been to one. When I was a kid, I used to run between the carpets, you know, because you used to have them propped up on the rolls of carpet and you could go behind them and it was like a den. Probably kids don't do that anymore, but I found it quite amusing. And I like the smell of new carpet as well. It makes an house smell like brand new, doesn't it? There's not much more left I need to do now, actually. I could just go home now, actually, I think. Could I actually say actually anymore? I think I actually could. That's a load of green out. Do you know what? I've not actually done a Sunday outside in Chiswick, I don't think, have I? Or have I? I don't really know. You'd have to let me know in the comment section down below, because I've done nearly 3,000 videos now. You have to let me know. Starbucks coffee coming up too. Not really a fan of Starbucks though. No. It'll be lies, won't it? You never get the broadband speed they advertise. There was a big thing in the media about it. They're saying that they're going to, they're forced now to give you more accurate speed advertisements and whatnot. But I don't think it happens. I don't think the government's got any teeth into regulating that sort of area. Because it's impossible, isn't it? I mean, what happens if everyone's online at exactly the same time? It's going to affect the broadband speed, isn't it? Right, a siren. Is somebody police?
when there's an emergency, you're not supposed to rush or panic, because there's already enough noise already from the sirens. So that's a tip for you. I could go to London Barrack, couldn't I? Shall I just to sneer at everything? It's so expensive in our London Barrack, that's ridiculous. Yeah, that peanut butter right there, £7. Yet in the Fona Bologna health food shop near me, £5. I don't know why London Barrack's so expensive. That's the paper chase I've just been in. Clarks. I knew somebody once who thought it was Clanks. I used to work with her out of shoes, and she thought that Clarks was Clanks because she'd never seen that. She'd never known anyone shopped in there ever. So she didn't know. Well, if you're watching from the international abroad area, that's Boots, which is the UK's biggest chemist company, really. I love Boots. Everyone likes Boots. Nearly everyone's got a Boots card to save the points on. And it's one of the points cards at Boots, which is one of the best ones, really. If not the best. Especially at Christmas. Never been abroad, so I've got no reason to go to our travel agents. I hate NatWest. It's nice just to meander around. I've never really had a set plan for this Meandering Monday, Meander Monday. No, I haven't even decided properly on the title. This is a Lloyd's Bank. There's a parcel that they've got in there which I keep meaning to share. And they completely conveniently omit the history of the 2008 part of the company. You know, where we had to bail out the banks to give them money because it was all about to go bust. And now, funny enough, that now we own them, they seem to be running at a loss. So they get even more money. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. And you can guarantee that once they're sold off, they start making billions of pounds again. Do you know what? We shouldn't have bailed out the banks, to be brutally honest with you. I think all the money should have been given to some of the startup banks to take the slack. And everyone's bank accounts should have been transferred over to them. Or something. Because we give all that money to the banks, didn't we, to stop them from going under. And we've seen absolutely no return out of it. Absolutely none. That's like a patisserie Valerie as well. It's like a bakery. I keep meaning to go in there. I've never actually bought anything from there, but I do know somebody who works there. No, he doesn't work there, but works near there, Jordan. And he got some cakes from there, and they're absolutely gorgeous. Really good. So I'll have to go to Gales. Especially if Pat Val still closes down some shops or something, because something's going to change. Something's going to change. Well, it has to. I think it expanded a bit too much. Yeah. Still randomly a gap in Chiswick. I'm never completely up what happens with gap. Is it going bust or not? Don't know. Don't know.
My phone ran out of battery. Look. Think 25, cashier confirmed over 18 for alcohol-free red win. red wine. It's got a taste of vinegar, isn't it? And at 0.05% vol. I suppose if you drank loads and loads and loads of this, you'd get the same symptoms, such as a headache. You'd probably be very, very sick. But I'm gonna do this as part of this video rather than a separate video. As an apology from a stupid phone running out of battery. It's going to taste of vinegar, isn't it? Have a good smell, future YouTube. What does it smell like? Does it smell like wine? Does it smell like red wine? Oh my god, it actually does not. It actually does smell a bit vinegary.
I'm not really getting much of a rub on that. Look at that. That is vinegar, isn't it? The only thing close to it is you get the same glug 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 effect. So if you like the sound, you know, ASMR. There you go. Oh gosh, that looks terrible. Just had another thought and all. If you spill this on a carpet, do you still use alcohol-free white wine? I know this is white red wine then. Do you still chuck a load on a alcohol-free white wine to get red white wine? Red white, I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. I'm stalling because I know this is gonna taste of vinegar. Oh my god, it actually tastes of vinegar! Oh, that is rubbish. If you don't drink and you're going for an alcohol-free wine, which it isn't really because it's 0.05, so if it's against your religion or something, why would you drink this? Oh, it actually tastes of vinegar. Hang on a minute, I've actually got some vinegar. Here is some fresh Heinz vinegar. I suppose this is the white wine version, I suppose. God, that does smell of vinegar. Surprise, surprise. That is actually nicer. I would quite happily drink that more than this. Than this. It's actually made it taste nicer. So maybe that's what you're meant to do with alcohol-free wine. Is you're meant to, first of all, have a shot of vinegar. And then when you go back to this, it actually tastes a lot nicer now. It actually does. It tastes a bit more fruity now. I've improved it. Well, I'm about to say scress and goodbye, but I can't leave without reading the blurb on the back, can I? What is it? Alcohol-free red wine. Aromatized alcohol-free red wine, it says. Now, this is going to be terribly accent-heavy. I'm sorry. I'm from all, and I've lived in London for 9 years, and I've still got the same accent. In fact, it might be getting even stronger and worse, to be honest with you. Worse is not a word, I know. Winemaker's selection. Our expert winemakers travelled the world selecting only the very best wines for you. Well, they didn't travel very well for this, did they? The alcohol has been removed from this wine to give a smooth and fresh drink with delicious blackcurrant and red berry flavours. It is a refreshing alternative to wine for those who do not wish to consume alcohol. Serve with tomato-based pasta or chicken dishes. Style, soft and fruity blackcurrant and red berry tomato-based dishes. What? Oh no! I've read all that wrong. It's meant to go in lines, but they've put a line there. So it made it a bit more confusing to read. And it is by Sainsbury's, and it's product of Germany, which, as we know, is hardly the best place for wine to begin with. I'm thinking of Blue Nun. I'm thinking of Black Tower. And now this. Germany, you and your wine seems to be quite always bad. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scress. Let me know in the comment section down below what you think of today's Meandering Monday. Or Monday Meandering. I've still not decided yet. I'm just about to go and make a title song for it. Anyway, thanks for watching, scress. Bye! What do you think? You love red wine, don't you?
Yes, I do. It smells okay. Actually, it's not bad. I was expecting it to be worse.
I thought it tasted like vinegar.
It does. But it's alcohol free.
Would you like to try some vinegar first? And then go back to that and see what it tastes like? Because it actually improved it. I liked it after I had a bit of this.
Yeah, I get your point. Yeah, it is. It's getting to me now.
Yeah, it's vinegar.
I'm going to have to take a Isidol or something. Thank you.
I'll keep it in the cupboard, so if someone comes round who we don't like, we can just give them a glass of that.
And fantastic tablet at the same time.
Yeah.